Okay, so we're going to do a bit of a test run here on something. Let's go host. We're going to do Valencia in Spain. We're going to do a bit of a test here on what to say. Let's see, what do we got in here? Tom Chilton. What's the car info on that? Wow, he's got shit tons of torque on that car. That's amazing. That's got tons of... Okay, let's do a test. Let's run with that. If that will let me run that, let's do that. We'll go with 25. Let's do... It's been a while since I was in Valencia, so I'm not sure. Let's do 103%. So the CPUs are well above... I'm guessing they go faster than the lap record on that. Auto gearbox off. Let's see. How many races are there? Practice session, yes. Two race format, no. Okay, good. So, let's try this out. And we will... Let's test this car out and see how quick it is, because I would say that a lot of the other cars have like half the torque that that thing is putting out, which seems a bit unfair, but I will run from back of the grid. Let me be clear. I will do some qualifying testing just to make sure that I've got reasonable pace in practice, and then I'll go back of grid. I will disqualify myself and go back of grid, and then I have 6 laps to attempt to get a good result using, in theory, a car that seems to have a technical advantage. Same horsepower, but more torque. So, and I haven't driven this car before, so I don't have a good feel on setup for this. I'm really just doing what I normally do. Let's have a look at gearing. Okay, so I'm looking to try and get something like 43 lap time. We'll be right back. interesting thing. That car has sharp oversteer at the beginning of the turn in, and then it has some horrible understeery behaviour. Weird. Okay, let's do it. Let's try. Straight to quali. I'm going to disqualify myself to put me at the back of the grid, so let's do that.
You're driving the wrong way. Disqualified.
Job done. So, now we go straight to the race. Back of grid. Okay. Alright. Let's do this. Needs more settled work, I'm afraid. I need less steering angle, and sixth gear needs another cog. And the steering is still horrible, I have to say. Right, let's try this again. Okay, let's give this a go.
We'll be right back.
haven't scored.
That was very bizarre. At no point did I feel like I had a torque advantage at all in that. Why am I 25th? I was not 25th. Let's go back here a step. Let's have a quick look here. If I go leave event, go same event. Let's do the same event. Let's do host. Let's do this. Let's take an older car. I quite like the Honda. But if you look here, it's like 200 Newton meters less torque than the car we just played with, which is the 2012 Tom Chilton. I'm not wrong here, am I? 300 brake horse. At much lower RPM. Perhaps I didn't use the low RPM in that. But it understeered a lot, that car. It really did understeer a lot. So we'll go with this. We'll go with the Honda. We'll go six lapper. 103. Right, same. Okay, let's give it a go. Let's see.
finish, you haven't scored any points.
Very odd. I do not feel that that car gives me any. This car here I feel that these, although it's got the same horsepower, torque feels like there's no real difference in the torque curves in driving as far as I could feel. So a bit bizarre. And this car has initial understeer that seems horrible. I did manage to sort it out a bit, but all the front wheel drive cars are easier to drive, but they all have understeer, especially once the tires start to get fried. So it is a challenge. Anyway, messing around on Valencia.